Good morning, students. Today we are going to learn about the Bohr's model of atom, and let's see what's there in the Bohr's model of atom. Okay, so what Bohr said? Bohr said that in the center of atom there is a nucleus. Around this nucleus, the electron is moving in a fixed circular path. You can see here in this diagram, electrons are moving in a fixed circular path. Okay, and these paths were having a fixed radius and definite energy. Okay, each path is having fixed radius and definite energy, and these paths were called as orbits or energy shells or energy levels. Again, I'm telling, in the center of atom there is nucleus. Around the nucleus, the electrons are revolving in a fixed circular paths. Okay, and these circular paths are having fixed radius and definite energy. That's why they were also called as energy shells, energy levels, and also called as orbits. Okay, and since the energy of each shell is fixed, okay, since the energy of each shell is fixed, so what happens, the electron present in the shells will also cannot change their energy. Okay, that what I said, that since the earlier in the previous postulate, in this first postulate, we have already seen that energy of the each shell is fixed. Okay, energy of the each shell is fixed. So what happens, the electron which are present in that shell, their energy is also fixed. That's why what will happen, these levels are also called as, these energy levels are also called as stationary states. Okay, they are also called as stationary states. Now, can the electron present in this shell never change their energy? Then electron present in an orbit can change their energy only and only when they are absorbing energy from outside or they are losing. Okay, they cannot change their energy with time. Okay, like 1 second one energy is there, after 2 seconds something energy is there. It's not like that. The energy of the electron present in an orbit will change only when they are absorbing energy from outside or they are emitting energy. Okay, the third postulate of Bohr's model is said that, now how many orbits will be there, means how these orbits, any orbit, any circular path will be called as orbit or what? Okay, it's not like that. Only the orbits which are having an angular momentum value as an integral multiple of h by 2 pi will be permitted. Okay, that means like if it is first shell, its angular momentum value will be h by 2 pi. If it is second shell, that means it is will be 2h by 2 pi. If it is third shell, that means angular momentum should be 3h by 2 pi. And if you are talking about the fourth shell, it will be 4h by 2 pi. So only those orbits will be permitted whose angular momentum should be in the integral multiple of h by 2 pi. Okay, so here you can see the mvr is equal to nh by 2 pi, where n refers to the number of the orbit. This also tells that the angular momentum here is also quantized. Okay, now as I told you previously, the energy of the electron will change only when they are absorbing energy or they are emitting energy. So what happens, suppose an electron is absorbing energy, so what will happen, if it is absorbing energy, its energy will increase. So what it will do, it will jump to the higher energy levels. Okay, it will jump to the higher energy level. The energy which level which is nearby the nucleus is the lowest energy level. It is also called as the ground state, and as soon as you move away from its energy level increases. So this is the, this level is having more energy than the first, third will have more energy than second, fourth will have more energy than third, and this way it goes on. So suppose if an electron is present in the second energy level and it's gaining energy, that means its energy increases. Depending on how much energy it gains, it will jump to that particular level. Suppose if it gains little bit energy, that means from 2 it will move to the third energy level, and if it is gaining more energy than that, then we can move to the from second to fourth directly also. Okay, so what happens, after reaching, suppose it has reached to the third energy level, now what it is having lots of energy in it. So lots of energy, that means that that state is called as excited state. Okay, when the electron gains energy and moves to the higher energy level, that state is called as excited state. And the excited state is what happens, it is the unstable state. Why we are saying it is unstable? Because lots of energy will be there, so electron will become unstable, and what it will do, it will try to come back. Okay, so it will fall down again back. So when it is falling down, it will release energy in the forms of radiation. Okay, so that happens if it is electron is absorbing or emitting energy. Okay, so whether when their electron is jumping from one energy level to another energy level, okay, definitely there is a change in the energy. Okay, that change in the energy is given by the expression del E is equal to E2 minus E1, where H nu is equal to del E. E ki value kya hoti hai? We have already seen the energy expression of the photon, where E is equal to H nu. And after substituting the value, we will get the velocity value as E2 minus E1 upon H. Okay, clear. And one more point you should keep in the mind, that what happens generally, if the nucleus is if electron is very close to the nucleus, or that means the orbit is very close to the nucleus, the attraction of the nucleus will be very much. So the electrons will what? If attraction is there, what? They will, the nucleus will pull it, and when electron will be pulled, then they will emit energy. That's why what happens whenever we are writing an expression of the orbit or energy, we'll write it as negative form. That we will tell next. Okay, so let's see that. Okay, one by one, the other important points of the Bohr's model. Okay, the radii of the Bohr's model was further used to calculate the radius of the various orbits also. Okay, so the what was the formula, where radius is equal to n square upon a naught, n square into a naught, where n is the number of the orbit, a naught refers to the radius of the first orbit. Okay, radius of the first orbit, that is that whose value is 52.9 picometer, and it is also called as Bohr's radius. Okay, same way we can calculate the energy of electron in a particular shell by the formula En is equal to minus Rh upon 1 square, where Rh is the Rydberg's constant, its value will be 2.18 into 10 to the power minus 18 joules. Okay, and for hydrogen like atom means which are having one electron, like He plus is having one, Li2 plus is having one electron, Be3 plus is having one electrons. Okay, so for hydrogen like ions, the radii expression is given well by Rn is equal to 52.9 into n square upon z, where z refers to the atomic number. And expression of energy for this type of particles will be given by minus 2.18 into 10 to the power minus 18 z square upon n square. So here you can see minus sign, and I already told you why it is so minus sign, because when the orbits are closer to the nucleus, the electrons present in them will be pulled by the nucleus, and they will emit red energy, and that's why there is a negative sign. Okay, and one more thing, if the electron is very very far away from the nucleus, that means orbit is also very far from the nucleus, so in that condition the net attractive force on the electron will be zero. So in that case we will take it as energy as zero. So if you are getting a condition like energy in the infinity state, that we will take as zero. Energy of the orbit at infinity, energy of the electron at infinity will be zero. Okay, and same is the case of the orbits also. If the energy of the orbit at infinity will be zero. Okay, now related to this, we will solve one numerical. That means calculate the energy required for the process where He plus is converting into He2 plus and E electron, and the ionization energy of the hydrogen like atoms. Okay, in the have for the hydrogen atom in the ground state. So we know that how we are calculating. So since we are doing the ionization means we are applying energy. Okay, when we are applying energy, what will happen? Energy, if it is, first we'll see what is ionization. Ionization means removal of electron from an atom. Okay, And for removing an electron from an atom, what you have to do? You have to supply energy. And if you are supplying energy, what will happen? The electron will gain energy and it will shift to the higher energy level. Okay. And after shifting to higher energy level, here it is not mentioned in which energy level it is going. So that's why we are considering that after excitation, it is going to infinity. Okay, that means the original state is E1, and that means our ground state is represented by E1, and after excitation, it is going to the infinity we are considering. So applying the Delhi equation, Delhi says that E2 minus E1, where E1 is the initial state and E2 is the final state. Here final state we are considering as infinity. So that means that's why we have taken as infinity. Now, just now I told you at infinity, E value will be equal to 0. So substituting the value of E infinity and E1, and we will get the answers. Okay, so first see for the hydrogen atom. So here what will be there? Infinity value is 0. E1 value is E value. I have just already seen in the equation that it is how to calculate the energy of an orbit. Okay, -2.1 into 10 to the power minus 18, where Z atomic number of hydrogen is 1 and N is the number of orbit. So hydrogen is having only one orbit. Okay, so after substituting this value, we will get the final answer as 2.18 into 10 to the power minus 18 joules. Okay, now same way we can calculate the ionization energy here. Okay, the ionization energy for helium also. For helium also the same case, we have to do the ionization. That means we have to apply energy. And when we are applying energy, electron will gain energy and it will move to the higher energy levels. That means here also there will be change in the energy. That means Delhi, and since we don't know where it is, which level it is going, so that's why we are considering that it is going to infinity after gaining energy. So it will become E infinity minus E1. Again, the value of E infinity will be 0, and substituting the value of energy of the orbit. Okay. That is -2.18 into 10 to the power minus 18. And since helium's atomic number is 2, that's why it will be into 2 square upon 1 square. And the final answer you will get as Delhi is equal to 8.72 into 10 to the power minus 18 joules. Okay.